You should be able to get it from another position and another position. So it's, you got to think about it, right? Everything he shows you, he develops. This is not something someone showed it to him. Well, he knew how to do a little plata, but then he figured out, how do I get in it from different positions? His style is also very different, right? If you watch like Hicks and Gracie videos, they talk about invisible jiu-jitsu. They call it how it's visible. Because I look at my partner, if he's not doing this, I'm doing something wrong, right? So always gauge your technique by your partner's expression. If they're uncomfortable and they're grunting, you're doing it right. If they look like they're at the beach and there's no pressure, that's not jiu-jitsu, right? So his style is very, very technical. Every detail matters, but a very powerful style. It's not about like pretty and going there and flow. And it's like, look at your partner, make a lot of pressure, make a lot of pain. And I felt it, right? I felt it for many years. So first, before we do promotions, I want everyone to thank Professor Hell.
It's an honor for me to be here, you know. I always tell people, you know, sometimes you're born with a family, like with the parents, but sometimes they're not your family, you know. And at the same time, jiu-jitsu brought up the biggest family I have in the world, jiu-jitsu family. You guys, Michu, we started like, about 20 years ago, we trained together, and we're still friends till now. And this is like, it's funny because it's more than a family. We're not just a team. Being a team is okay, but be more, be a family. Like this year, I go to different countries, and I know people that I met when I was a kid, and it looked like it was yesterday. And this is a great feeling for me. It's a great feeling to come over here, see the kids of my kids. And you guys are. Thanks for being part of my family. I'm not bullshitting you guys, man. You know, like, if you guys go to San Francisco, same house, it's the same thing. You know, that's what I try to pass to Michu, I try to pass to all the guys that teach. It's fortunate the guy that come from the white belt to the black belt to the same guy, especially nowadays. Because you see like many different places, people hopping from one academy to another, and have one student like him, representing me from white to black. I know if he goes to hell, the devil will be afraid of him. I know for sure that. And all my students that becomes my black belts, I know anyway they're going to represent me. And that's, thank you, Michu. You're part of my family, brother.
Yesterday about his family, right? As he mentioned, this goes beyond jiu-jitsu and sports. Like, you really become part of the Gracie family. His grandfather had 21 children, 13 black belts. And he gave birth to 13 black belts. Literally, they came out of their black belt. he had 106 grandkids while he was alive, and he had 130 great-grandkids while he was alive. Like, he populated half of Brazil. You became from that part of that family. Very few sports, very few things in life, you can trace your lineage, right? Alf got his black belt from Carlos Gracie Jr. and his father, who got it from Carlos Gracie, who invented Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, right? So you're essentially three generations back from where his sport originated. And even beyond that, someone, you know, Carlos Gracie developed Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, but someone showed him Judo and basic Jiu-Jitsu, and he turned it into something else. And so you're only five generations away from the founding of Judo. Tell me any other sport, baseball, football, anything, where you can trace who taught you something. I trace my techniques to Hal, he traces it to his father, he traces it to his grandfather, right? And that's what jiu-jitsu becomes. 20 years ago, I walked into his gym, scared as hell. Like, I read an article about this guy, the pit bull. Like, I want to learn jiu-jitsu.
And that was nice back then, right? Much nicer now, right?
Much nicer now. Right? Like, it was my first day, I didn't know anything, and I tried to out-muscle techniques, and I got, you know, you have 150-pound guys, and I'm 220, and throwing you around the mat. It was something magical, and he wanted to learn more and more. And that's why it was important to me. So today's very important, because not only am I giving you a black belt or a belt, it's Professor House's belt. And it's his father's belt, and it's his grandfather's belt. So it means a lot to everybody. Okay? If I call out your name, I want you just to step forward. Okay? Professor House is going to hand you the belt. and then one of the black belts will tie it on you. Okay? We're gonna start with blue belts, then purple, then brown, and then two black belts. Okay? At the end, we kind of stopped doing the whipping, but today we're bringing it back. So you get to take out your aggression on someone who may have tapped you a bunch of times. Okay? At the very end. Okay, blue belts, we got the list? All right. So Chung's gonna hand step forward one step. Chung will hand Professor Help the belt.
I'll tie it too.
He'll tie it for you. Okay. Of the black belt, you just sit there and look pretty. Try a little bit harder. Okay, should I call your name? Just step forward and Help will make the way around. Jesus.
Should have been a doctor.
Can't tell. All right, no brown belt. I can't read the names.
It's at the top.
He's on the text thread. Yeah.
The Hulk, sir.
Thank you.
too many more white belts in here, but best piece of advice I got when I was a white belt from a black belt was don't show up 5 days a week when you start out. Show up 1, 2, 3 days a week, whether it's Monday, Wednesday, Friday, whatever, but make sure you're there. Rain, shine, snow, just be there. The biggest mistake I see the white belts make is they get off the couch on January 2nd and say, I'm going to do jiu-jitsu 7 days a week, followed by Muay Thai 7 days a week. In 3 to 4 weeks, you've never seen them again. So keep it consistent, and then you get addicted, and then come as much as you want. 7 days a week, twice a day. So, second thing is, a lot of you guys I don't know, but I trained under Misha for 6 years at the old gym. Now I train in Columbus, Ohio, a GF team. We send 30 guys to Worlds every year. Some of the best guys in the world. But the competition thing really isn't my style. I've always loved Misha's style. I love the guy. He knows about 10 moves, and he smashes you with everything. Just those 10 moves. Grinding. And very reality-based, no spider guard, no nothing fancy. So I really love this style of jiu-jitsu, Ralph's style of jiu-jitsu. But the most important thing, I think you can get good at any gym, go down the street, go here, you can go there. It's about the individual and your goals. But I stayed with Misho for this line. I said, Misho, I'd like to get the black belt from you. Because Misho is my friend, he's a great guy, and that's the most important thing. I've never had any of my other instructors call me just on a random day, hey man, how you doing? What's going on? How are things? So I really appreciate that about Misho, and I guess to their point about this being a big family, that's why I'm still with Misho. I'll represent Misho for forever and Ralph forever, and I appreciate it, guys, so thank you.
You gotta love the training, right? Show up, even when you don't want to show up. You can show up, watch, whatever's the case. Improve a little here and there. Over time, it will happen. Okay? All right, thank you guys. He's already winding up.
Yeah.